Well, he was known all over the world for his success in the energy industry, but Boone Pickens also known for the millions he gave the Oklahoma State Athletic Department. But some might not know what Boone Pickens did for academics here at OSU.
He's made a huge impact for OSU and how generous he's been, so I was pretty shocked. But he's a good man.
Students remembering one of OSU's biggest fans. The 91-year-old made his fortune in the oil fields of Texas, but donated more than $500 million to his alma mater, OSU.
Boone Pickens will be really, really missed, but Boone Pickens will never be forgotten.
Dave Martin is the former deputy athletic director for the university. He says the deep pockets of Pickens put OSU football on the national map.
You'd be surprised how many schools, big universities, Big Ten, other Big 12 schools and things have come here on campus just to go through and see our facilities. He was just a great fan. I mean, he was there all the time and you could always talk to him.
Maybe one of the greatest misconceptions about Boone Pickens and OSU, it wasn't all about sports. He gave millions to academics too.
No, we haven't seen him around like we used to see, but sad day. He's done a lot for the university.
Dave Stein is a professor in the Ag Department. He says Boone's legacy scholarships have and will continue to benefit students far into the future.
I supported academics in a great way. Very fortunate to have him associated with OSU.
It was just sad, especially being a geology student. It was kind of eye-opening just to see how big of an impact it was on the whole campus and even the whole state.
Today, OSU President Burns Hargis calling Boone the ultimate cowboy. A service, a celebration of his life will be held at Gallagher-Iba Hall. Time and date to be announced. From Stillwater, Brent Skarkey, Oklahoma's News 4.
All right. Thank you very much, Brent. I had the good fortune to spend some time around Boone over the years doing some special report profiles on the oil and gas tycoon. This is from last year when my wife Ginger and I had a chance to visit with Boone in his suite at the house that Boone built. This was during an OSU game, and the last time I spent a lot of time with him, a few years ago, we did a special report on him called the OSU Money Man, and he wanted to make sure before the football game he went and visited the basketball team because he used to play basketball at OSU back in the day. And of course, all of the alumni there on campus wanted to come see the man who gave $652 million over the years, but he never wanted to talk about himself with him. He just wanted to ask them about how they were doing. And as you saw from Brent's story earlier, when it came to the game, he was very serious about watching his Cowboys from that 50-yard line suite with those binoculars right there.